Right, guys. New JR business video.
What up?
Who do we have here? We
got Kieran.
Our boy.
Hey, what's going on?
Got our boy Hayden right here. Drop shipping expert, resident drop shipping expert. We figured we'd get him in this video because he's in town from where?
Minnesota.
Minnesota. He had to come pay us a visit.
Well, he wanted to visit me.
It's not entirely true.
You want to visit all of us in our beautiful cars and everything.
Yeah, yeah.
So, like I said, master in drop shipping. He knows all sorts of stuff about it. So that's why for this video, we're gonna go into
5 main keys, things you need to know. We're gonna talk a little bit about eBay, different principles that apply to all sorts of e-commerce.
So. Shopify,
Amazon. Drop shipping, a little bit of Amazon.
5 things you must know before starting your e-commerce business, because there's a lot to know, and I guess
there's a lot more than 5.
And here we go.
So the first topic that we're gonna hit on, it sounds super cliche, but it's true, and we're gonna tell you why, and it's be different, be unique, and don't do what everybody else is doing.
This is exactly true because everyone in today's day and age, everyone and their dog wants to do drop shipping. And you need to stand out in some way, like we've said in a lot of previous videos, you have to be different in some way. It applies to all businesses. You have to stand out and find your niche and find out what you're good at and really diversify yourself from the competition.
It's very true. I think the biggest thing, at least that I see between people who do all right or even fail with drop shipping versus those who make a lot of money with it, especially long term, the people who do really well with it are the ones who will actually go and create the trends. They don't just, you know, piggyback on that and follow what's working. They'll pick the products that are already starting to do well and have the potential to do really well, and they'll just blow it up from there.
Yeah, how many people do you see drop shipping necklaces and bracelets and fidget spinners and all these like these hot things that other people have already made their money on? You see all these people making hundreds and millions of dollars, hundreds of thousands and millions of dollars on Shopify. Guess what? They're the ones who started the trend that you're now trying to follow because you see those sexy numbers. I shouldn't say sexy.
You should keep that in, we're keeping that in. They had the gut feeling and they were able to do all the research to figure out the products that had the potential, like I was saying, to really blow up, and they ensured that it did blow up.
Yeah.
Obviously there's a lot of products that they went through that didn't do well, but once you hit that one that really works well, it's just game over from there.
Yep, and I'd say just always gotta be aware of when a market is too saturated, because if you're trying to go into a saturated market with everybody doing it, it's gonna be a lot harder.
There's always money to be made if it's saturated again, but like why would you wanna go into something where it's gonna be harder? Don't purposefully make it harder for yourself.
All right, topic number 2, hit them with it.
Don't fall in love with your store, your products, or your ads.
So this is something that I actually still deal with. Whether it's for my social media marketing clients or even I do a little bit of e-commerce, I do a lot of affiliate marketing. I have to obviously run ads and advertisements on Facebook and Google and Instagram and all these platforms. And sometimes I'll make an ad that's just so amazing aesthetically, or I think the targeting is absolutely perfect and I'm running a retargeting ad for my Facebook pixel and I just feel so, so confident in that it's gonna work. And then I check back the next day or a week later and it's just not working. There's no conversions, I'm spending way too much money, the cost per click is way too high. And I fell in love with that and I was too emotionally attached to it because I'm like, man, this is gonna work. I spent so much time on this, I love how it looks. And that's a downfall for me, and it still happens to me. And you can't let that happen. You can't get attached to something just because you think it's gonna work. You have to let the data speak for itself. You have to let the market speak for itself.
No, it's very true. You're definitely gonna make ads, especially pictures that you think work really, really well, and they look good, and you think they're gonna do well. But again, it's the same thing with picking products. If you think it's gonna do well, that's not just what makes it do well. You have to, you know, base that off of research, all these different factors that go into it. Again, based on the stuff you've learned, and it's so much testing, so many different variations that actually go into it.
Yeah, and knowing when to cut your losses. If you're spending all this time trying to make it work, you would have been better off to not put in any time, just to cut it, do something new. So you gotta always be coherent of this stuff in your head. And yeah, it's kind of like stocks as well. Like with stocks, you get all emotionally attached, and say it's starting to crash and you're like, oh, it's gonna go up, it's gonna go up, it's gonna go up. But if it keeps dropping and dropping and dropping, you are just gonna mess yourself up big time. So you just gotta know when to sell off and put in something else, so.
It's very true, and it's actually interesting he said that, because that's a point I wanted to talk about that I don't think either of you guys know about me. That's how I got started with entrepreneurship. When I was 12, I started trading stocks. That's how I spent my days in school every single morning, waking up early for market open and not really listening to what the teacher said, so. 4 years spent learning the fundamental basis and all the technical analysis behind that, but I came to realize that the one thing that really separated the traders who made money consistently for years and years versus those who didn't is they didn't get emotionally attached.
Yep.
And I couldn't really separate that, so.
Topic
number 3.
We are now gonna be talking about barriers to entry and especially why some e-commerce platforms have very low barriers to entry, which can be a good and a bad thing.
Exactly, I'm sure you guys have heard about the main three, Amazon, Shopify, and eBay, and there's very distinct differences between all of them. And I'm gonna point out the very obvious here. Amazon, you're buying all the products up front. I'm sure some of you have done that or are looking into doing that. So if you have the capital to work with up front, you can do very well with that.
Which is a barrier to entry.
Exactly, that's a barrier, I mean, for some people. So, you know, you gotta have a couple thousand to spend on the product. Right. Whereas Shopify and eBay, in some cases, you don't necessarily need to do that. You're fulfilling each individual order as it comes in.
Yeah, Shopify's probably in the middle, still very low barriers to entry, but you still have to pay the Shopify to have your Shopify store and stuff. Whereas eBay, I guess that'd probably be close to the lowest barriers to entry. You pay 10 cents to list your item and pay a whatever 5 to 10% seller's fee. Like, that's very
minimal. And one thing with Shopify that I always point out is it has a 14-day trial. All the apps and plugins that you need have at least a couple day to a couple week trial. So you can really kind of get in and figure things out and then go from there. That's when you start paying. So ideally once you're actually making sales.
So like I said earlier, low barriers to entry are both a good and a bad thing. It's nice because a lot of people can get involved for fairly cheap and not have to do too many things to set up their business. But then again, the huge problem with that is, like we said in the first point, everyone's trying to do it. All these people come in because they're like, oh, low cost to start a business. They see all these nice looking numbers from other people and they're like, I can do it too.
They see the cars, they want to do it, but
that's
a good and bad thing. You got a whole lot of people trying to do it.
Good and bad thing. And high barriers entry, again, good and bad thing. It was tough for me because it took me years to get into some of my businesses that are high barriers entry. But it's also super nice because I don't have to worry about telling these goons about them and they're gonna knock off my idea.
There's not a lot of people who can actually get that capital to start it up.
So. Topic number four.
Influencer marketing. So we're gonna be talking about something specific to kind of my business and what I do, and a lot of people who are actually doing Shopify dropshipping, this is what I would recommend to you. There's way too many people who try and start out with Facebook ads who don't really know what they're doing with it. So I would recommend kind of straying away from that. Even if you have a course or guidance that goes through that, I would really recommend and really push you to try and stick to Instagram influencer marketing. 10 seconds for those of you who don't know what that is. You're paying an Instagram influencer with an audience to put your product in your store in front of that people.
I haven't done too often, but like me occasionally.
If you want to pay Jeff to put your stuff in front of his audience right here on YouTube, there you go.
Influencer marketing is a great way to kind of begin, you know, building up.
And it's super underpriced right now.
And I'm gonna tell you why it's, yeah, we'll get into that in a second, but I'm gonna tell you why that specifically relates to Facebook itself, because you're gonna have your pixel already installed on your store, so all the sales, all the data, add to carts, traffic, everything you're getting from those shoutouts is being tracked by Facebook, so you can use that data for what, at least in my opinion, is the hardest part of Facebook, picking the targeting. So you just use the lookalike audience and run from there.
There you have it.
That's what I would recommend to scale. You know, get consistent, get some sales, some momentum, really learn the business, and then you can really exponentially blow it up with Facebook, which is what I'm doing right now.
Sweet. You heard it from the man himself, but you think it's cheap, Kieran, right now? You think?
Yeah, I think severely underpriced.
Yep.
Influencers don't properly know how to price their stuff, especially story shoutouts. I would use that feature with the swipe up. That right there is the most practical
tip
I can
give. That's very true.
They don't know how to price it.
Let's go, Hayden. Bring the fire. Man, I'm loving this. If you guys are enjoying the video so far, be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you're new. We're always doing videos like this. And always, if you want to see more content about this subject, drop shipping, Shopify, any e-commerce platform, or other business videos themselves too, drop it down in the comments below. We always say that, and we always try our best to make what you guys want to see. So go ahead and do that. Okay.
Topic number five.
So, another super cliche topic that is still really important to understand is...
Nothing is as easy as it seems. I don't care if it's Shopify, you're doing Amazon, eBay, anything. Social media marketing agency, flipping cars. Really doesn't matter what it is, but nothing's as easy as it seems. I thought, you know, Shopify was a lot easier getting into it. I had so many friends doing really well, making a lot of money. But, you know, I didn't exactly see those results overnight. Nobody sees the grind. You guys don't see when we FaceTime Jeff with the question, it's 4:30 a.m. and he answers immediately because he's on his phone working. You guys don't really see that. That's, you know, shout out to people, you know, shout out to Jeff for that and a lot of entrepreneurs who are actually out there putting in the work, because that's what it takes, and most people don't really show you that, you know, not so glorious side.
Yeah, I feel like people just see the glorious side, the money, the cars, this and that and that, and they don't really know what goes into it. And they think it's simple, so they just walk into it thinking like, okay, where's my paychecks? And doesn't work like that at all. But you got a lot of you guys already know that. We stress that a lot. A lot of you guys know what it's going to take, and I love that about so many of you guys. But
in e-commerce specifically, and what we're talking about today is Shopify and eBay and Amazon, each of them requires so much knowledge and so much preparation, either monetarily or just in terms of your own knowledge about the subject. You know, of course, you have to be prepared to front the risk on Amazon. You have to be prepared to learn about Facebook ads on Shopify. And there's just so many things that are a lot harder than everybody makes it seem. You know, if there's 1,000 different levels to Facebook ads, and there's 100 different ways to run a good ad, and there's so many different things that make it difficult to create a good ad, and then, you know, you have to really test and split test your products on Amazon. There's just so many different factors that make each of these e-commerce platforms difficult. So when you see those screenshots, next time you see somebody on your Instagram stories with a sponsored thing at the top saying, swipe up to learn how to make $10,000 a day on Shopify, think twice, make sure you realize what they're actually telling you. You know, it's really nice to see those numbers, but you have to realize the work that goes into it.
Exactly. It's taken him years to hone in Facebook ads and social media marketing and that sort of stuff. It's taken you a long time to more hone in on Shopify, even though you haven't been doing it for
It's only been like five or six months, if even, but like those skills, you know, I've been building for years on stuff
because
like Facebook ads. I got started in social media with Instagram like three years ago with Instagram influencers. I was the influencer. I was building those pages.
There we go. So yeah, you learn new stuff every single day. And with eBay for me, I've been doing eBay for years and years and years, and I learn new stuff every single day. So it's important to always be learning and to always realize just what it takes to grow any sort of business in today's day and age.
And I don't think you should let price be an issue. You know, we were talking about Instagram influencers. Yeah, you're gonna have to pay them. It's not free. There are ways you can do that. You know, the stuff I talk about on my channel, which I don't personally do because I do have the money to work with. But I talk about that because I see people with no money who make absolutely no excuses and actually put in the work. You can go do what's called a rev share and tell an influencer, look, I'm gonna give you 50% of whatever we make on this ad. And if they're smart and they know their page brings value and is gonna get the customers, they'll know that they're gonna make more money on the back end than just the initial shout out cost.
Well, affiliate marketing.
You're gonna have to reach out to a lot more people and put in more work because a lot of influencers are gonna decline that. But you know, there are people out there who will say yes, you just have to find
So many tips and tricks you can learn. Like I said, learning every day. So always plug the YouTube account, Mr. Aiden here.
Yeah.
It's linked down below, check it out. He's got some good content. He's got some great stuff about business. It's kind of like Jared Garage and Jared Business combined almost. He's got like the lifestyle vlogs of him traveling, and then you got the business content to back it up.
I hope that brought some value to you guys and maybe cleared up some questions that any of you viewers out there had.
So we hope you guys valued a lot from this video. It was fun to make. We're always happy to make all sorts of different JR business videos. So again, comment down below what you want to see done next. Comment down below if you want to see an extension of this video, some more tips and tricks. Again, this was only five. There are way more than five.
Let us know below what car you think I should go do donuts in the parking lot with.
Oh.
Make Jeffrey.
Okay.
Make Jeffrey do it.
No problem.
And also, before I forget, guys, if you're interested in working with the Shopify platform that we've been talking about, the one that Hayden's like killing it on right now, go ahead and there's gonna be a link in the description. We'll say something like Shopify there. If you guys want a 14-day free trial to kind of test the platform out, definitely click on that link and sign up. Again, it's a 14-day free trial. You have 2 weeks to kind of figure out, you know, get everything in order, figure out if it's for you. So again, go ahead and click that link and check out Shopify.
That's gonna let you kind of test and figure out what works, start making sales. You can do everything on the free trial. That's what I always recommend over on my channel, is to actually get things going while it's free. You know, like we said, there is a trial to everything, so that's kind of a very, very low barrier to entry right there.
All right, so once again, Hayden, thank you for joining us on this great video. Oh yeah.
Thank you for having me, sir.
The classic handshakes, yeah. Bingo. So like I said, drop a comment down below, leave a big like, subscribe if you are new, and we'll do it again sometime.
We'll look forward to seeing you next video.
Next video. Bye-bye. Bye.